Hi, Leo. I hope you're doing well. Thank you so much for coming in and spending time with me. I really appreciate it. Please only take with you what resonates and leave the rest behind. This is for Sun, Moon, Rising. Let's see what is going on for you. All right. Okay. You have the High Priestess, Six of Swords, and the Death card. Wowee. Quite the group. Queen of Pentacles, King of Swords, Nine of Wands, Eight of Wands, the World, and the King of Wands. I can tell you this is a very strong time for you, okay? Very strong indeed. And now at the bottom of the deck, your overall energy, you have the Four of Swords, and your overall energy is saying that you need to make yourself a priority, okay? You need to take care of yourself, and whatever it is you need to do, do that for yourself. Be kind to yourself, okay? All right. So let's talk about these. Or first, let's go ahead and get a few oracle cards to go with this. Trust in divine detours. So there might be a divine detour coming up for you, Leo. Quite possible. Ghost. All right. This is saying that there could be somebody or something coming back from your past, into your life during this time. Blessed. Beautiful. You gotta love that. All right. Now let's take a look. Okay. Your recent past, you were using your intuition and your psychic gifts to help you go forward, and it was helping you get to smoother waters, be in the flow with the universe. And it brought in a major transformation. And if you notice, you have two major arcana here. So that was probably a big change. Here you have the Queen of Pentacles. And for me, she is definitely balance. Her income is good. Her career is good. Her home life is filled with love. She is a slower moving, very secure, earthy kind of energy. And she is so balanced. Here, you have the King of Swords, and the King of Swords is very wise, and he bases all his decisions on what he knows to be true. So you have this beautiful, grounded, lovely energy, and this very adamant, on-point, logical energy. He sees clearly, and he speaks and makes decisions on the truth. And that's in the center of your reading, so everything is about wisdom and your truth. And here you have the Nine of Wands, which is talking about you being protective over something. It could be this brand new transformation. And it could also be that here you are needing to make yourself a priority. Okay? In the future, something very positive and quick moving is coming straight into you. And it's something that you're passionate about. And here you have the World, which is the end of a cycle. You've worked all the way through a particular cycle. And this is one where you should be proud of yourself for your efforts. Yeah. And you have the King of Wands, which is saying you are going for your passion. And Leo, you're showing up here, definitely. So the King of Wands goes for his passion. He's very strong, very adamant, and he tends to get what he's after. Okay, so over here, you can expect the possibility of some divine detour. which you can see right here. This could be the divine detour. And here, something from your past could be coming back into your life. And it could be a person, but it could also be, say, a desire that you had, something you wanted to do. It could be just about anything. But the very last card, the end result, is it's going to be a blessed time. And I can tell you it's a powerful time because you have, let's see, you have three major arcana. Almost all your cards are court cards outside of that, with the exception of the Six of Swords, which is going for the smoother waters, you know, having this beginning of going for your happiness. Excuse me. The Eight of Wands, really fast, positive, moving energy. And the Nine of Wands, where you're going to be protective. So it, to me, this feels quite powerful. And in the center, you do have the King of Swords. Everything is going to be based on your truth. Okay, let's go ahead and clarify. And remember, be open to divine detours. That might be the very thing that changes your life exactly the way you want it to be. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see what we have here. You have the Nine of Cups. By using your intuition, it's going to bring in much happiness. Okay. Let's get a card for the Six of Swords. You have the very same card here that you have in your future. Very fast, positive, moving energy coming right into you. And this is where you are leaving something behind to go for your happiness. So this could easily be the news that you're waiting to hear that leads you to your happiness. Okay, let's get a card for death. And rebirth. Okay. Here is the Three of Pentacles. This is saying that, you know, you might be working with others or dealing with others during this time. All right, let's... Whoa, that jumped right out. Queen of Pentacles. You have the Chariot. So the Queen of Pentacles is very, very stable. And it's saying that you are very adamant. Whatever this transformation is, you want to go for this. And so you're very steady, very well balanced, and you want to hurry and do it. So you do have, so far, three cards of this reading that are fast-moving energies. Now, at the bottom of the deck from taking that, you have the Ace of Cups, which is saying this transformation is going to be one that's filled with love. So it's something you're going to be very happy about. Okay, now for the King of Swords, you have the Knight of Cups. Love. You're taking action, going for love. And this love can be anything. It can be romance. But what it is surrounding yourself with what you love. But to me, it's an absolutely beautiful energy. So you're taking action towards that, and that is your truth. That is what you want. Okay, now the Nine of Wands. Oh, decision time. There could be potential for some confusion here. But you are guarding this. And what I'm feeling about this is not guarding this decision time, but guarding the decision that you're making, right? These four are beautiful energies. And you're going to be guarding that decision that you make. Because it's going to be a wonderful decision. Okay, now for the Eight of Wands in your future. Another beautiful card. This is the Page of Cups. You're ready to go forward. You're ready to get this started. It's a beautiful energy because it's filled with love and intuition and positive, fast-moving energy. Okay, Now for the world. All right. You have the Six of Pentacles. So you're bringing in balance. Which is huge, because when you're balanced, you're in the flow with the universe. And remember, up here in your past, you were leaving something behind to go and be in the flow. Here, you're in the flow. You're closing out of a big cycle and putting yourself in the flow with the universe. Okay, going for your passion. Very adamant, very strong. And that is the Eight of Swords, where you're feeling stuck, right? So I'm sure this is getting out of that energy. And it's coming out right below here, right? Okay. Working with others, having a major transformation, feeling like you have to make a decision, and guarding the decision that you're making, which is getting out of the stuck energy and going for your passion. And at the bottom of the deck, from taking that, this is where you and everybody you love are going to be very happy. Love that. Okay. Now one for your overall energy. By making yourself a priority, you know, and doing what's in your heart and doing what you need to do to build yourself up to where you need to be, you are rising up and going to a new level. It's beautiful energy. Okay, let's see what the universe would like to share. Love it. Okay, the Two of Wands. This is where you are going for what it is you want. You're holding the world in your hand, right? And you're going to be leaving something behind. And to me, this whole reading is kind of like talking about that, preparing you for that. Yeah, major transformation, going for what you want. And you want love, happiness, joy. And to fulfill your passion. Okay, and look at that beautiful new beginning of Pentacles. So this is an opportunity for you to start something that is most likely going to be really beneficial when it comes to your finances. You remember, you have the Queen of Pentacles here, and she is very secure in that. Yeah, so it looks like this transformation includes this, and you're going for your Queen of Pentacles. Okay, and that's confirmation of the challenge that you were feeling here, right? And potentially some of this feeling like you have to guard. And it could also be, let me kind of move these over a little bit. Here, you have the King of Swords, right? Seeing clearly, knowing clearly, using wisdom. So this energy can be a hurt heart, right? But it can also be where it's like there's a fog between you and the truth. So there was a period of time where you weren't seeing clearly. So it could be both. But, yeah, this is the universe telling you, you know, what was going on, what's coming in. So it's wonderful. And at the bottom of the deck, from taking that, you also have the Ace of Wands. So this new beginning, this big transformation that you're having, you know, closing out of this and having this big transformation, it's going to be all about your passion and bringing in the Pentacles. Yeah, love it. All right. Let's see what the angels would like to share. It's up to you. Of course, it's up to you. Yeah. You have free will, so everything is up to you. But, you know, include everything that's going on and make the best decision for you. All right? And here it's also saying yes. And you see these two cards, or not two cards, these two orbs, right? They could be the sun and moon, but it's balance. So, yes, go for it. All right, let's get a charm to close this out. And don't forget, your very last card here is you are blessed. So things are going to turn out beautifully. And here you have a key. So go forward knowing that by taking these actions, you're going to be opening the door to your future that is quite beautiful. Thanks so much. I really hope this helps. Much love. Bye.